everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. Here we've got a couple of big targets who will try to be key contributors in both the pass and run games today. It's the 49ers going up against the Dolphins. With that, let's get you to a hot and humid South Florida as we welcome in our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis. Guys, stay hydrated.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the San Francisco 49ers and the Miami Dolphins. Hi again, everybody. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we saw Larry focus on the tight end matchup in his open. You think it's one to watch, don't you?
Definitely one to watch because these guys can create such big plays by all the different things they can do. Line up out wide, in the slot, line up in a normal tight end position, and then who are you going to cover them with? Is it a linebacker, a defensive back? They create mismatches all throughout the game.
Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon, and we are underway from Miami. This fielded at the two. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. And we're about to get a look at San Francisco on offense. Quarterback Colin Kaepernick, week 10. They only lost by 3 to Arizona. Good game. He threw for 210 yards and a touchdown on the ground. 10 carries, 55 yards.
And for him, even though they lost the game, there has to be some satisfaction in having a good game against Arizona, because the last time Colin Kaepernick started in a game against the Cardinals in Arizona, he threw 4 interceptions and lost his starting job the very next week. So he kind of exercised a few things in this one, and he's starting to get better and better as the season goes on.
First carry for Carlos Hyde. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 11 on the gain there. And that leads to a San Francisco first down. Now, Carlos Hyde had missed the previous 2 games with a shoulder injury coming into week 10. And nowhere to run in week 10. Just 14 yards on 13 carries.
And that is so uncharacteristic of numbers Carlos Hyde would normally put up, especially in a Chip Kelly coached offense. Because one more time, let me just reiterate this. It is a run-first offense. Everyone talks about how fast they go. They're not doing it to throw it around. They're doing it to run the ball and set up play action. And Carlos Hyde just couldn't get going.
They run again with Hyde on first. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Carlos Hyde's a physical, tough runner. Had a few dings, but I don't think he should change a thing in terms of style. And I think that playing in Chip Kelly's offense gives him a chance to catch the ball more as well.
He can do both with him, Kenny. And he said he's excited to be in that Chip Kelly offense.
I think the versatility will really be to his liking.
So we've reached the end of a fairly even first quarter of play. Nothing-nothing our score. And we'll be back to South Florida after this.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Snickers. You're off your game when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies.
Second quarter now. Brandon Gordon, Charles Davis with you. It's the 49ers in control of the football. They face a 2nd and 7 to start things out. Throw on 2nd down. Smith catches left side. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. D Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. They'll run it. Here's Hyde. And he gets this one across midfield for the first down of the 46. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. So here we go, first and 10 now. Now whistles here, and I think one of the big boys for the 49ers might have jumped.
False start, offense. Still first down.
And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. Here we go on first and 15. Shotgun snap now for Kaepernick. Surveying the field. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line.
That was a really nice interception. I think it illustrates the differences between playing man and playing zone. When you're in man, all you're focused on is the receiver in front of you. But when you're in zone, you're allowed to read the quarterback's eyes and go to the ball. That's exactly what happened on that play.
Interception. Here's Tannehill. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And he's brought down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Tannehill looks for Parker, and it's intercepted, picked off by the corner Tremaine Brock, and he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. Hit as he threw it. Charles, that ball's got to come out quicker.
It does, and the way that that happens, know where you need to go with the ball in pre-snap. Has to read the coverage, has to have a great idea so he knows he can get rid of it right now to an open receiver.
Because he had no back in there to protect him with that five wide set.
So you know what, you become your own blitz control because you've got to deliver the ball and know you're going to get hit.
And San Francisco gets set to go here. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
So after the INT, it's Kaepernick. He's got time in the pocket. And a diving grab. I think he got that. Yes. They'll get 19 yards there. And the 49ers are going to get a first. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. They go play action here on first down. Incomplete. And we're down to 8 seconds now. Torrey Smith, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle, but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
Second down now after the incompletion. Kaepernick will try again on second down. Complete to Quentin Panton. And he is out of bounds, just a yard or two shy of the 30. A big completion there, and he gets out of bounds to stop the clock.
Very heady football. That allows them the opportunity to go ahead and line up and kick one right before the half ends.
So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. This is a 49-yard attempt, right hash. And the kick for the 41-year-old is up and good. So we've reached halftime. All we have to show for the first half, a lone field goal. 3-0 our score. As we check in with Larry Ridley in Orlando, he's standing by with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Let's take a look back at the first half. Both the Dolphins and the 49ers haven't figured out yet how they're going to move the ball through the air. The defenses on both sides have kept points off the board, and it will be interesting to see if they can keep that up. All right, let's roll those moving pictures.
Okay, Larry, thank you. Just a lone field goal in that first half. Will the offenses show up? That's now the question. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This is fielded at the goal line. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Dolphins offense now working their way back onto the field. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Now it's the Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
And that's another stop for the defense, something we've seen all game long. They've been on fire today. No matter what's called by the offense, they've had an answer for it.
And he will lose yardage on the play, back at his own 19-yard line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll force upon him a 3rd and 14. And yet again, this run game just continues to be completely shut off.
Completely stymied. I mean, they're trying to get some consistency, trying to find places to roam. They just haven't been there throughout this game.
And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now in Miami. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. An extra DB for the 49ers now on third. They'll look to throw. And nearly intercepted there. That would have been ball game if he had clinched it and caught it. Instead, it gives him one more chance here on fourth down. And now they're going to go for it. This isn't fourth and inches. This is fourth and 14. He'll look to throw. He's got time. And now he lost the football. Tannehill loses it. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And you can just about put this one in the win column for the 49ers.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And San Francisco gets set to go here. They have the three-point lead. Defense did their job. Now, late game. Although it looks good, you know the coaches, they haven't counted this as a victory yet.
I agree with you totally. Big applause for the defense, but no one has taken their headset off on the sidelines. They don't believe this game is over. The offense has to close this one out by taking care of the football.
And they'll try to close it out now. First down, a run with Hyde. And he's going to battle. Now the Dolphins are going to halt the action here. It's a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. San Francisco touchdown. Carlos Hyde taking it in from 2 yards out. And the 49ers add on to their lead.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable. But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Out comes the Miami offensive unit now. They get set to take over. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again, but they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly, then they'll take it from there.
Incomplete. Deion Sims is tied in the intended target. And it's second down.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. Tannehill now to throw. Finding time. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by the safety, Eric Reed. And his guys will set up shop at midfield at the 50-yard line.
Obviously disappointing, but you had to go for broke here, down 2 scores. So that forced you to make some throws you definitely wouldn't want to make. And I think this interception is going to pretty much write an end to this one.
Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. 2 timeouts remaining defensively, but that shouldn't make much difference right here.
It really shouldn't, but a lot of coaches look at it similar to baseball with the intentional walk.
Always bringing in other
right? Sports.
Always,
hey, listen, think about the intentional walk, right? What if one gets past the catcher? What if he uncorks a wild one and now you still have an opportunity? That's why they like to use them all the way through.
Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them. Now the Dolphins are going to take another timeout here. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Down to a knee for the 49ers. This one about to be on ice. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. So a defensive timeout. Chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. Looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. And the ball game should end here on the kneel down by Kaepernick. Here's Bradley Pinion now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. The storyline in this one, Charles, no doubt the number zero. Zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is, and what an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a full team. There's a lot of pride that goes into shutting out an opponent. And how about that zero on the scoreboard for them, going along with those zeros in the time column, too.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com.